Hi, I'm Dr. Mark Heller of Learn Low Force and a dynamic chiropractic columnist. We're talking today about one leg standing. This is a companion video to our article in Dynamic Chiropractic about one leg standing. These are a couple of simple tests to determine the overall stability of the person's core, for one, and secondly, to determine function of the gluteus medius. Let's start with the overall stability. We'll be doing what we call a load transfer or weight transfer test as developed by Barbara Hungerford, PhD PT of Australia. I've got these dots on Rebecca on the right PSIS, the right sacrum at the horizontal same level, the left sacrum, and the left PSIS. I'm starting out with my thumbs strictly on the right side, level horizontal. I've got my eyes lined up, so I've got a good visual. I'd normally be directly behind her, but I don't want to block your view, so I'm over here. She lifts up her left leg just a little bit, and we can see what happens. What happens? Her right PSIS goes forward, indicating the muscles aren't activating quite the way we'd like them to. Come on back down and do that same thing one more time. As she shifts there, my right thumb goes up, okay? She failed the weight transfer test to the right side. When she puts weight on her right leg, the muscles aren't working. Now we're gonna test her left side when she raises her right leg and puts her weight on the left. I'm going to put my hand on the left PSIS and the left sacrum. She's going to lift up her right leg, and we get an appropriate response where the thumb drops down a little bit. Let down. We're going to look at that one more time. Go ahead. So when the thumb drops down, the PSIS is rotating back, putting her into better stability, a posterior rotation of the ilium, indicating an activation of the multifidi, the glutes, and other stability muscles. That's a good response, we might say negative in the medical world, versus the other side where she went that way for a positive or bad response showing instability. That was the weight transfer test. We're going to contrast that with Gillet Stork test, the original. In this one, she puts her hand on the wall to stabilize herself. I'm going to have her lift up her left leg way, way up, up high. We're trying to get motion in the joint. We see the joint move, let down, and the other way. And again, the sacrum moves down here, okay? And on the right side, lift the right leg. That's a normal motion. And lift up, go, lift up the left leg again. That's okay. The one that was a little iffy was over here, lift the right leg. Her left side of her sacrum isn't rotating back. But I want to contrast these two tests. The Gillet Stork test, what we're looking for is their normal motion. On the weight transfer test, we're looking for stability. The second one, Gillet Stork, is a test to determine hypomobility. Do you want to manipulate something? The first test, the weight transfer test, is not about manipulation. It's about rehab. It's about how well do her muscles work to stabilize her when put under the challenge of putting the load on one leg only. How well does she do one leg standing?